There's a shopping cart full of retail news tonight, and none of it's good, starting with hundreds more job losses at Darrell Lea.
Danny Isdale is at their city store tonight. Danny, at least the crippled chocolate maker has found a buyer.
Well, Bill, that's the good news. The bad news is that 400 Darrell Lea employees will still lose their jobs. Under this restructure, those positions will be made redundant and 27 stores will close their doors within the week. Now, you will still be able to buy Darrell Lea goods from other licensed retailers and wholesalers. And looking longer term, the brand's former iconic status will be restored. That's if the dreams of the new owners are realised. The Queensland-based Quinn family have taken on Darrell Lea. They're best known for selling pet food. This is a new challenge, but they are hoping to save the company, to save its manufacturing jobs and, of course, to keep it in Australian hands. Now, to get to this point, though, it has been a sad decline for Darrell Lea, with very little money to be made, and unfortunately, that seems to be the case across the retail sector at the moment. The latest ABS figures out today, instead of showing an increase as forecast in retail spending, actually showed a decrease for the month of July.
While the catwalks couldn't be more colourful,
neon is huge this season.
It's been a dark day for Australia's retail market.
Clearly, these are disappointing figures today.
Despite forecast growth, retail trade in July slumped 0.8%.
We've seen a drop in every state, including the resource-rich states.
Department stores took the biggest hit, down more than 10%. On the bright side, cafe and restaurant owners enjoyed a 0.3% jump, and now the sun is starting to come out. We might be too.
The weather, Sydney, food, it all goes hand in hand.
I think people just like to eat outside in Sydney, so it's a bit of culture.
You think people just want to have a good time?
Exactly, that's it.
But what our retailers want are customers keen to spend.
And we certainly hope it's a wake-up call for the RBA in their consideration tomorrow of what happens with interest rates.
The National Retailers Association fears its industry and the 1.2 million people it employs depend on it.
Bill and Sandra, the RBA is actually tipped to keep rates on hold when its board meets tomorrow.
Danny Isdale, thank you.